Okay, light is green. Welcome, welcome. Name again is Don Higgins. I am artist illustrator. I work with FASA Games. Welcome. I am, like I said, the art director for FASA Games. I work with their primarily their 1879 line. I am a little bit involved with Earth Dawn, not the art director there, but that's James Austin. But I work with Earth Dawn a little bit, doing their Champions Challenge comic, web comic and graphic novel. I'm also involved with the Hey Penny Pie web comic and graphic novel. I write and illustrate both those comics. 1879 is the sandbox that Hey Penny Pie plays in. I am involved and Earth with EtherStream and Interceptor, the FASA Games space battle game that I'm heavily involved with. That one I got a little bit of involvement with Demon World, and I'm busy. So lots that I'm doing, enjoying it, having a grand time and doing a lot of different things. Today I'm going to work on something that is 1879-ish, I think. Something that, as a fan of H.G. Wells and Jules Verne, I am going to do something that's kind of in that realm, steampunk and that kind of thing. Going to play a little game with that one, and hopefully it's something that you guys will enjoy. Before I get started, as I do every week, somebody asked me a while back, almost 2 years ago, they asked me if there was anybody I could have in the studio that would be a guest. I could talk with them and draw their portrait. And who would you invite? Anybody in the world, who would you invite? And the first name that came to mind was, and I'm hoping the sound is working here. Let me know if it's not. But first person that came to mind is Jason Momoa. Why? Because he seems to have fun wherever he goes. And I think he would be a blast to have in the studio. Share a pint, draw his portrait, talk art, talk creativity. Someday, maybe. I mean, hey, there's Guinness in the fridge waiting on him. Like I said, it would be great to have him in the studio and talk art and creativity and whatnot. And maybe someday. Who knows? If you know him and you know how to get in contact with him and you know if it's something he might enjoy, reach out to him. Let him know about this and how to reach Derry, New Hampshire. I've expanded a couple of times as far as who else I would love to have in. Johnny Depp, Helen Mirren. I don't know why the name jumps, but Helen Mirren, again, she seems fun. Zoe Saldana. Yeah, she seems fun and would be wild to have a sit down and talk art and creativity and how she does what she does and how they do what they do and how everybody. Yeah, it would be fun to have them in, and someday I'll be able to have a guest like that in and talk art and creativity and draw the portrait in the process. So today, because there's an 1879 Kickstarter running right now, welcome to the Grove. I am going to do something 1879-ish. Very H.G. Wells and Jules Verne type of a thing. So, without further ado, let's get over to the drawing venue. Hello. Come on, get over there. Yeah, there we go. And boom, there we go. And now, and then go. I'm ready to go. Should be, yep, on the right layer, on the right tool, on the right opacity. And you can see these are the kind of things that I'm going to be working with today. This is my reference. So, start with some basic shapes. Most relevant that I see first is that claw area. And then this leads off of that. And some of this stuff has gotten away because it's fuzzy, so I'm gonna have to guess and go with what I can see. And because this is going to be sci-fi-ish, there's a lot that I can get away with as long as I get the basic shape correct first. All right, and then there's a leg that does that. I've started with a toned paper, something that is going to be more akin to the sea. Is a background color. And let's do that. Let's move him away. You can see what I'm doing here. Nope. Move him to where I can see him. Back onto the right layer. No! There. All right. Can I see? I can see joints and whatnot. How did I get my opacity off? There we go. Because that's wrong, that's why. All right. So let's fix this before I mess everything up. Okay, that's got that. Now there's going to be this big section here, which comes off of it like there. There's that. That comes off like that. Shape. And that comes over like that. Let's move him out of the way. Let's go back to this guy here. Basic shapes, basic shapes. This is a split that does this. That comes around like that. And this is this again. There's this that does that and has barbs and what have you. This, it'll have barbs. Alright, and then this I'll have that. It comes around like this. Starting with base shapes, guys, to get a look, to get a feel. And this is going to have a couple of these guys doing this. And what I intend to do with that, because I can pretty much put him aside now. So now I can concentrate on the rock face, but what I want to do is I want to take him and bring him over and let's scale him just a little bit. Transform. Nope. Transform. Scale. Bring him down just a hair. There we go. Now I want to take this guy. Bring him over here. Alright, now, let's take that information. What are we going to do with it? We've got this rock face. Going back to the right thing. Do some things here. Let's put something in there. I think you can see where I'm going now. What am I going to do with the rest of this information? Move that up. All right. Great thing about this piece is that the bulbousness of that helmet going to allow me to do a lot. There's a hand. Sweeping line here. Eyeball. Ah. Give this guy a feeling of panic. Very nice. Let's get a little more reference on the shape of things here. Bigger on that bulb. There we go. That could be cool. That could be quite cool. And then that have that come up like that. And off the page. Yes. And then we'll have bubbles, 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 bubbles. Vegetation of some sort there and whatnot. Okay. How's that for a setup? I watched episode 6 of the Book of Boba Fett this morning, and although I like it, I like everything Star Wars, but it seems like the Mandalorian's taking over because it was more about him than Boba Fett. But I'm liking the show. That, and I've got the theme song in my head. All right, let's change the opacity of this layer. Gives me the background. I'm on the wrong layer. All right, now then, let's go back to this layer. And I'm on that pencil, and I'm going to change the opacity of the pencil. And do this. Now let's get a little more involved here. Come on. One of the things that I made the mistake of recently is I bought Tony, my art director, my fiance as well, but bought her a DVD set, which is Challenge of the Super Friends, the old 70s show. And I'd forgotten how bad it is. Oh, God. Now, to be fair, it was entertaining to a 10-year-old. But these days, my palate has changed, I guess, is the best way to bring this out. And what did thrill me then is not so big a deal anymore. All right, now there's a lot that I cannot see. because it's fuzzy in the reference. What I can see, I'm going to... play games with. Make this a little bit more interesting. Terrifying. Very cool. I am liking this so much. I'm gonna do some things here. Add to his view here, and he's a little more menacing looking. cool. That's gonna do that. Very interesting, very. Outlining a bunch of stuff here so that I can go back in with some other tools and clean things up, make some things stand out a bit more. But I'm having a good time. I hope you guys are out there and are able to hear this. give him some more. Like crustaceous type stuff that is growing on him. Give him a little more ominous of a look. This thing's been around for a while, and he's got just some more to him. This so that I can play games with that. Yeah. Oh yeah. All right. Not too much, just enough to give him some more of an ominous tone here. Remember, I'm going to go back and add some white and some other things to him. Very cool. Very, very cool. Oh, here we go. Thank you, Tim. I always count on Tim to let me know if I'm messing up or not, and fortunately this time I'm not. He can hear me. And this one's going to be a fun one. This one already is a fun one. I was saying earlier, I've got that theme song to Boba Fett in my head, and very Maori or Maori or whatever you call it. I don't know how the pronunciation goes, but it's very tribal, and I love it. It is a fun thing. This guy's really coming together. And do some of this. forget. Let's do... this, and we're gonna... to this layer. There we go. And it's definitely pulling something up out. Let's go back to what I was working with. And get that guy back. Nope. Here we are. So that I can get these pieces right. Very nice, very nice. Change that. Get that out. There we go. Round we go. Define the leg structure. And then there's one more leg. That. Very cool. Very, very cool. All right. I love doing these pieces within the realm of the games that I work on, even if there's nothing written on this piece yet. There's no game, no lore on this creature. But I will probably give this guy over to the powers that be. In this case, it's Brad Decker, who is the line developer for 1879. And we'll see. What he can come up with. For this guy. Barbed area. Okay, and we're gonna change the grain to add something to the shading. All right. Now let's go under here and add. Big rock. Big rock. Nature. Cloud. Rock big. Now let's see. Right. To where are ya? Chalk. We're going to define some of these edges. Very cool. Very cool. Alright, and now I'm going to delete, not delete, but hide that, so I can go back in here with my pencil. And get this guy. Okay, so that's in. Uh-oh, got a new piece of music in my head while I'm working on this piece. I am suddenly got the, music to the original Johnny Quest in my head. Isn't this cool? Isn't this nice? Okay. Guesswork here as far as where the folds would go. How is that, folks? How's that for drama? Oh, messed it up. Very nice. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring the weapon to bear. Give this guy some shading here. Now let's put that back in. Back to that, and go to my eraser tool. How is that looking, folks? So, what am I going to do now? Let us do some stuff. Let's add. Nope. Where are you? Where are you? That's smoke. crusty texture. Bring that down. This down. Down. Why? Try it a different way. Try. And on that layer, and hit. Ah. Okay, there. Interesting. Very, very, very nice. All right. Now then.
We're going to go to...
Start adding... That
come up to where are you?
That one. Bring that down. Now we're gonna go to nice and thin. Okay, let's go with some debris. That was wrong. Nope. Let's do this. Thank you.
this.
Change something here. Get that background right. Come on, where are you? Thank you. texture or two in here. Information here. Okay, I'm almost done. It's a very interesting piece so far, but I'm almost to that point where I want to not futz with it anymore. So now let's do some of this. Thank you. one more layer. Here we go. I don't see any questions, so I'm gonna just err on the side of judgment and keep going. That to that. A little bit more here. Oh, yeah. This is cool. I am so loving this. And now look at that. And that. Now, what I'm going to do is let's bring this down so we see the whole image. What do you think of that, guys? Now, before before I mess it up. And you show brushes, 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 brushes. Boom. Very cool. So let's get rid of that, that, that. Ooh, better not do that. What did I do? Yep, that guy needed a lot of attention. Don't need that, so what I do need to do is get rid of this. Because I was on the wrong layer. So what I'll do now is I will go to my proper tool here. This right, come on. I think I'd have it down by now. And that's all she wrote, folks. That is my homage to 1879 and to H.G. Wells and Jules Verne. Something steampunkish. Nice piece. Had fun. Hope you guys did too. you guys really need to give me some questions while I'm working. It would really help me through. But hope you enjoyed it. Name again, Don Higgins. If you know Jason Momoa, if you know how to get in contact with Jason Momoa, tell him there's Guinness waiting for him in Derry, New Hampshire. Love to have him in the studio and talk art and creativity, etc., etc. So, that in mind, if you do me the honor, follow the advice that I hope to instill in people is draw what you see, not what you know. Be patient with each other. Be kind to each other. And like I say, draw what you see, not what you know. Me? I see dragons. Why don't you? Have a good day. Bye-bye.